In this Dynamo for Civil 3D example, we will be placing signs along a freeway corridor. Those signs will come from a CSV file or an external file where we've identified the station, the offset, and the sign type for each of the signs that we want to place along our corridor. Those signs are inserted as 3D blocks, and we have a warning sign, a regulatory sign, and a freeway directional sign that we'll include in those blocks. So let's go to the Manage tab and up to Dynamo, where we'll launch Dynamo now. Once Dynamo comes up, we're just going to select New. One of the first things we want to do is set our run type to manual. This just avoids any sort of unnecessary runs before we're ready. So what we want to do is select our current document, which is going to point at our current CAD file, and we want to select the corridor by name. So we'll select that node there and connect those. This gives us a chance to select the exact corridor that we're interested in. Here we'll input a string value, select that there, and we'll move there. Now, in the corridors that we have to choose from, we are interested in the eastbound corridor. That's the one that we're going to choose, and we'll type that in here, eastbound corridor. Keep in mind, it is case sensitive, and we want the text to match exactly. Now, once we have that, now we want to extract the baseline, and we want to do that by name as well. So under Civil 3D, or Civil Objects, and under Corridor, we're going to select baseline by name, and we'll connect the corridor nodes. And we'll just copy this string element, just a Control C and a Control V. And keep in mind that we're not looking for the alignment name. We want the baseline name that's part of the corridor. In this case, it's BL-57. So we'll type that in here. And we'll connect those nodes as well. Once we have that, the next step that we want to do is to identify our CSV file that we're going to be reading from. We have a couple different options. We could use a file path node and browse to the file, but what we'll use is a data import, and we want to select the CSV node. Here, this also calls for a string. We'll do the same thing. We're just going to copy and paste that string node that we've already used. But in this case, we want to go and find the exact file. And so we can copy the path of the file that we're going to use, cut and paste that, and we'll paste that in here. And now we'll provide the remainder of that name, which was Eastbound Sign Inventory Road CSV, and we'll connect those. Now this operation is a Boolean, and it's asking us if we want to transpose it. We do, so we'll select a Boolean operation. We'll set that to true, and we'll connect those nodes. Now the next thing we want to do is to select the get item at index. We need three of these nodes because there are three pieces of information that we're extracting from the CSV file, the station, the offset, and the sign or block name. So we'll connect those from our CSV file in our list, and we'll set up a code block to determine which column we're reading. So for this first, we'll set up the code as 0, and that's going to read the first column or the stationing. The second we'll set up as code block number 1, which will read the second column or our offset value. And the last code block we'll set up as 2, and that will read the third column or our sign or block name. Let's give ourselves a little bit more room here, and we'll move those. Now, once we have that, we want to set up a coordinate system so that we're able to place these items. And we're going to select baseline coordinate system by station. So our station is identified in that first column, so we'll connect those here. And it's looking for a station and a baseline. Station comes from that first column, and the baseline is the one that we've identified in our corridor. So next, we will extract the x-axis for each of the coordinate systems along the baseline, and this is to define the orientation of the signs as we place them. So now that we have the stationing set up, let's set up the offset. We do that by typing out, we're going to use the points by coordinates. And that node will be fed from the, move those a little bit, we'll provide that from that second column that where we provided the offset value. So we'll connect our coordinates here. And now we want to set up our rotation for our elements. We're going to do that with vectors. We're going to use a little bit of trigonometry here, and what we'll have to do is set up our x value and our y values. Let's move those just a bit. But what we're trying to return is the degree of rotation so that it knows exactly how to place these items. We're going to do that with a code block. We'll set up an opposite value, let's select colon there, and an adjacent value. And we're going to type in a function that's math.arctangent, and we're going to take the opposite over the adjacent, and then we're going to subtract 90 degrees so that our sines are perpendicular, but they're oriented relative to our alignments. And that the x value is our opposite, the y value is our adjacent. Since we are placing blocks in this CAD file, we want to set up our node for our block now, and that's block reference, and we want to use the create option. This provides a handful of parameters, and one of those is the rotation. So we'll connect that to the rotation degrees parameter within the block reference. And we want to make sure that everything is being read in the correct location and position. And we're going to use a geometry transform node, and we'll connect the coordinate system from there. The geometry is going to come from our offset, and that's going to go into our position so that everything is placed in the relative position that we want it to be. As far as the blocks that we want to add, we're going to select block by name, and we want to connect that from the third column in our list, so we'll connect that there, because that was feeding it the name of the blocks. The document is going to come from our current document. We want to be sure that those blocks are accessible within the CAD file that we're in. Now, one of the last items, we're placing these in model space, and so we want to add a model space node here, and that's going to connect to blocks, and the document source, it comes from our current document as well. And the layer is just requiring a string. We can do that with a code block or a string. We'll do a string in this case. And here we're just going to specify the name of the layer that we want to place these road signs on. And let's just call that road sign. Now, once we have our script complete, we can take a look at it, make sure everything looks to be in its correct order. And we'll select run at this time to see if we have any kind of issues. All right, and it looks like we do have a handful of warnings. And these warnings are created because of our lacing. When we view the values that are returned, we only have three values in our list. And this is because our data import is reading the three columns from our CSV file. And so we'll right-click and select lacing, and we want to use the cross product rather than automatic. What it's doing in automatic, it's just returning the first value, but we want to return all the values. So let's run that, and it looks like it's run correctly. This warning is due to our coordinate system just because it's a very large model. But when we move this out, we can see in concept view, it looks like it has placed those signs, and it's placed them in the position that we identified in our CSV file. So we can see that Dynamo is a very powerful tool, especially when we are using external sources of information that we want to incorporate into our workflow.